Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel, The Real Rant Review. We're back with you, yes, for another awesome rant review. I love to get to do an awesome rant review. Thanks for joining me. Of course, spoilers ahead, as you know. I'm going to freestyle my thoughts on this movie, then we'll go through the plot. The movie is Rear Window, 1954's Rear Window, featuring James Stewart and Grace Kelly. Yes, Grace Kelly, guys, phenomenal. James Stewart, one of my favorite. Guys, give this man a chance. Rear Window, before Disturbia, before the remake of this movie, there was the Christopher Reeve remake. There was Rear Window with Mr. James Stewart, Jimmy Stewart. Guys, give this movie a chance. It's in color at that, okay? Alfred Hitchcock directed. Now, you would think Alfred Hitchcock is coming at you with some horror. Boy, oh boy, but does he do this in a way that scares you in a way where you shouldn't be looking at your neighbors, you know, like you know, you shouldn't be looking at people, you know, you should mind your own business sometimes, and this movie shows you that, and we're gonna go through it in the plot. But like I said, I give my thoughts, and I thought the movie just kept me engaged the whole time. Mr. Jimmy Stewart here, and the relationship between him and Grace Kelly, it's just a beautiful, they're together, they like each other, but then again, they're not full on together, you know, like they're, it's hard to explain. That's why it's cool, because there's a hard to explain relationship. You know they love each other, but it's going to take a little more to get them to get together. And at the end of this movie, you'll see that what happens to between them does fulfill that need, that closure to get them fully together. So really cool in that little sidetrack story by Mr. Hitchcock. But when we focus on the movie itself, does it get slightly boring at times? Yes. Yes. Alfred Hitchcock movies are known for that. They're known for slow pacing. They're known for drawing things out. But that's the build-up, guys. And he's known to build up. He is one of those directors that will build up a movie. So this is what he does with this movie. He builds it, builds it, builds it, builds it, until finally you know it's going to fucking explode. Okay? And it does. So hats off to Hitchcock, as always. You know, God rest his soul, and Jimmy Stewart and everyone else. And you know, they were great what they did for the time, at the time, and even now. So let's go through the plot of this and wrap this awesome rant up. So I'm gonna try my best, guys. I do have Wikipedia open. I will try to freestyle as best I can. I like to just do it off the top of my head. So if I miss things, excuse me. We should have seen this fucking movie. I'm telling you, watch it now, and then come back. Leave me a comment what you thought. So we start out here. We meet Mr. Jimmy Stewart. He's living in an apartment building. What happened? He's a writer, a photographer. He's a photographer for a newspaper, a journalist of sort. He happened to have an injury, so he injured his leg, and he's in a wheelchair for a couple of months, guys, or a couple of weeks, or what have you. So he has his girlfriend come over, Grace Kelly. She comes over, and she's cool. She's spunky. She helps to lighten his mood, because he's feeling really down. He's not used to being, like, you know, isolated and secluded into one place and not having nothing to do. So she gives him some ideas of some things to do and stuff, and tries to make him laugh and says, okay, I'll meet you later, whatever. But anyways, what happens is to occupy his time, there's an apartment building right across the way, and he has a great view of it. And people, it's summertime, you know, so it's beautiful. I think it's New York, so people are leaving their windows open. I think it's the city, and they're leaving everything open. Don't hold me to it. And he sees with binoculars, so he gets binoculars out in those times, and he starts looking, and, you know, he sees people doing different things, and he starts, every day then, he's more and more interested in other people's lives and what they're doing, and it keeps him entertained, right? So Grace Kelly, his girlfriend, comes over from time to time, and it fills her in on what he's doing, and she doesn't agree. She says to Mr. Stewart he needs to stop spying on the neighbors. That is wrong. You're invading their privacy. But Mr. Stewart says, you're right, I will stop. But Mr. Stewart here can't stop. So he still does it, but as he's doing it, there's one night where he hears, I believe he hears a scream of some sort or something, and he thinks nothing of it. The next day, he goes back to do his spying, and he notices a man that had a wife, and this man is packing up a suitcase, and the wife is nowhere to be seen. And she hasn't been seen. He hasn't seen her for a while. And the man, the husband, is packing up a suitcase and leaving. So he's a little suspicious, you know, because he's been watching for days, and he saw the wife, and I guess the man argued previous to this, and he heard the scream. So he's starting to think things, you know? He tells Grace Kelly, his girlfriend, about his suspicions about maybe something happened over there that night, badly to the wife, and that the husband did something. She does not agree. She scolds him again. You know, you're fucking nuts. You know, you need to fucking stop. There's also a guy involved, guys. He's a detective friend of Mr. Journalist Man Stewart. Stewart asks him to help to run a check on this man that lives next door. It comes clean. Everything comes checks out clean on the man. The wife, the patient, apparently went on vacation, guys. So anyways, so Mr. Stewart isn't convinced, though. You know, he's all on his own, guys. He's on his fucking own. And listen, he's immobilized, no protection. So he's got to be really careful from this point on to not be, you know, uncovered, not be seen, not be noticed. But how's he going to, you know, find information out? Well, he does it by spying with his binoculars like he's been doing. And what he notices is that there's something strange about a garden area in the front of the apartment building he's looking at. It's been dug up or something. There's something strange about it. I don't know. There's something strange or something. See, guys, this is where it gets a little confusing to me, but there's something strange about it. But regardless, what happens is, this is the main hit here. He gets, finally, his spying gets him caught. He does not listen to his girlfriend. He doesn't listen to anyone. The fucking guy, the husband, catches him red-handed, looking at him through the binoculars. Okay? He fucking catches him. And he stares his ass down. And Mr. Stewart is staring as well. So Mr. Stewart here is not afraid, but he gets afraid because Mr. Stewart starts to realize it's just him and this guy. And there's no one really around to help. And you know what I'm saying? Now he knows. So they both know. So Mr. Stewart starts to try to make a phone call, okay? He doesn't make a phone call, excuse me. What he does is, he makes a phone call, but I believe it's to police or something like that. He makes a phone call to the police, and he tells the police that this guy murdered his wife, you know, again, you know, and there's something that might be buried in the garden. Go check the garden, you know? So the police go there, they check the garden, and where he said there might be something, there's nothing. There's nothing. So they leave. After they leave, the man now has his opportunity, and he takes his chance to come in to Mr. Stewart's apartment and try to silence him and kill him, because he knows that Mr. Stewart is onto him. Yeah, since those cops came, you know what I mean? Fuck all that. He came. So what he does is the stranger guy, the husband, comes into the room and he asks Mr. Stewart, you know, how did you? You know, how did you know? You know, like, he asks him in a way where, like, how did you know? You know, like, he wanted to know, how the fuck did you know that I did this? Like, I thought no one would know. You know what I'm saying? I did it perfect. You know, no one knew. How did you fucking know? How'd you see? Mr. Stewart, I believe he doesn't answer. He's in defense mode. He takes his camera out. He flashes the camera very, very, very brightly to blind the man as the man's coming forward towards him, so Mr. Stewart can't move. He's in the wheelchair. He's trying to back up and flash the camera to get away. It's flashing. And it's a cool scene by Hitchcock. The man's coming forward, and he gets closer and closer as the flash dissipates and it goes dark. The man is closer. It flashes. He's closer and closer. He finally grabs Mr. Stewart, grabbing Mr. Stewart by the neck, trying to choke him, eventually trying to throw him out the fucking window of the balcony. And this is his big mistake, because a lot of people are hearing this screaming from Mr. Stewart, and they come out of their windows that he was spying on this whole time. Now they're spying on him, and they see him, you know, almost being killed by this man. The police are there quickly. They're able to run up and save Mr. Stewart, and I believe the man is either thrown off the balcony or arrested. You know, don't hold me to it. Either way, the motherfucker should be dead. Yeah, I think he's arrested. You know what I'm saying? Put away for murder. Grace Kelly. Then it's a couple months later. His leg is healed. Grace Kelly and him get together again. But this time, guys, you get to see a kiss. Like, you get to see a really good kiss, a really good hug between them, and he's in a good, you know, he forgives her for not believing, and it's a really, it strengthens their relationship, because now she trusts him more, even in the craziest of situations, and he's a hero. He has something to write about as well. And it's a great movie. End of movie. Close the curtain. Mr. Hitchcock performs. Guys, check out Rear Window 1954, I believe. Please watch it. Let me know what you think. Leave a comment. Let me know. Fuck yeah. Rear Rent Reviewer. We're doing it.